A society to have order and to protect its citizens must have rules. Rules or laws are created and agencies are formed to enforce the rules. In the United States, you are innocent until proven guilty. Our judicial system, our courts, have the task of determining guilt. When guilt is found, the courts mete out the consequences. Join us now as we see an actual Lake County court in session.
Could everyone raise your right hands, including visitors? Do each of you swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, and this you do under the pains and penalty of perjury? Okay, you can put your hands down. Each of you has a right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you. When you get to the microphone, I need to know if you're under 18. I need to know if you're not a citizen of the United States, because pleading today could affect your immigration status. I need to know if you're on probation or parole, because if you plead today, it could affect your probation or parole. If you plead today, you're giving up your right to have a trial and to have an attorney represent you at that trial. If I sentence you on a criminal case today, you're going to have mandatory costs. Those costs are in addition to whatever I do here, and the least those costs can be are $273. If you have a battery case, they're closer to $700, and that's in addition to whatever we do in here. If I put you on probation, you go outside these double doors, and there's a little room right on the left. As the door opens, it'll hit the little room, and you have to report to probation if I've given you probation as a condition. Today, we're being tape recorded and videotaped. Next, we have Lee Kaiser, Kaiser Lee.
Lee Kaiser is what I am.
Timothy Lee Kaiser, okay. And this is also a violation of probation. All right, I think I need to appoint the public defender to help you because you've got the felony charges.
Yes, and the only thing I'm worried about, like I says in there, that we'll be homeless pretty much.
But you won't get out of jail no matter what I do today because you have the felony charges. Do you have a public defender on your felony charges?
I do. I put on the kiosk.
Do you?
Miss
Angie? All right, let's appoint the public defender on all your cases right now so they can get going on it.
And we'll delay it more or anything?
It will speed it up.
Okay.
All right, so we're appointing the public defender on everything, including his felonies, okay? And could you scan that, please? Okay. Good morning, this is Judge Miller. At arraignments, I have Timothy Lee Kaiser, 2014 MM004481. I'm appointing your office on his violation of misdemeanor violation of probation. He also has a lot of felonies, and your office had not been appointed. I'm doing a suborder right now. So could you get the felony division moving as quickly as possible on this? Thank you. All I can do to help. Stuart Murphy. Mr. Murphy, you're charged with driving with a suspended license. It appears that you were habitual, but the driving law license suspended violated your probation. You're suspended because you didn't pay the payment plan.
Yes, ma'am.
And you didn't pay a Lake County ticket, two Lake County tickets. All right, we need to appoint the public defender for you also so they can try to work out a package deal, because anything you do today will mess up your felony case. All right, we're going to appoint the public defender. You want us to appoint the public defender on the felonies also? Yes, we'll do a suborder on him also. I don't know how two people slip by. All right, we'll appoint the public defender on all of it.
Your Honor.
Feeling better?
Yes.
Your name?
Kathy Holton.
Holton. You also. You have a large history, but you only have one prior theft. But given your total history, this is 10 days in jail. How did you get here today?
My mother.
Where's your mother? Could you come on up with her, please?
We couldn't do probation, Your Honor.
10 days in jail, given your history. You have a prior theft. And you've been in trouble a lot. So your choice today is you accept the 10 days in jail. You get credit for any, I don't know if they arrested you at the time. I don't think so.
They didn't.
So it'd be 10 days in jail. Or you can say not, you don't have to give her that because you can say not guilty. If you say not guilty, I can appoint the public defender. There'll be a $250 minimum charge for their services. But because you have a prior, you can be sentenced up to a year in jail. So the 10 days compared to a possible year, the 10 days is pretty lenient.
I'll take the 10 days.
I'm not trying to twist your arm. I'm just trying to tell you. And there's restitution if there is any. I don't know if they got everything back.
They did.
Why aren't you getting your act together?
I just took something back into the store. Somebody else took it, but they charged me with it because it was stolen property.
Well, you were asking for money for it.
No, a public's card. I wasn't asking for cash money.
Card's the same thing.
Same thing.
It's still...
I wasn't asking for money.
Yes, you were. Card's the same as money. So if you can't afford to buy food, then there are several programs in Lake County that can help you have food. But you have a mother who cared enough to be with you today. I have so many people who come in and out who have no one in the world who cares about them. And some of them still manage to get their act together. You have a mother who cares about you. It's time you get your act together.
But I hadn't been in any trouble, Your Honor, in 14 years.
I don't remember it being 14 years.
Well, until my daughter-in-law.
Let me double check. I don't remember it being 14 years. I just remember reading your history and saying, this is like the longest history I've seen.
I was being good.
Are you working?
No, ma'am. I'm on disability.
So you're getting government money and still allegedly stealing. The theft was, I think, in New York.
Yeah.
And you're saying 14 years. This says that you had an aggravated battery in April. 2013, you had a resisting without violence. Okay, if you played today, it's 10 days, and I hope it's a turning point that you'll do something productive with your life. So it's your call. You can say not guilty. I'll appoint the public defender.
Or 10 days.
All right, then yes, give your mother the phone. How are you able to afford a phone?
It was my dad's.
How can you afford the monthly payment?
I don't have it. It's not on. I play games on it.
She's remanded to custody. She needs to be printed. It's 10 days. And I'll reserve the right to restitution just in case everything wasn't returned. Is that, you have bronchitis? You said?
COPD.
How will we deal with that?
I'll have it taken across the street, Judge. They'll call medical.
Are you okay to go across, to take it across to the jail?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for doing that for us. Is there enough to last 10 days, or does she need to bring another one?
Yeah.
Okay. So you knew what would happen today, pretty much. Yeah. I hope I never see you in trouble again. I wish. Yes, sir?
Lucius Herring, ma'am.
Mr. Herring, you've been charged with an expired tag more than 6 months. I had trouble telling whether this was a first offense or a second offense, and here is a prior. You had a prior in September, the same charge in September.
Yes, ma'am. 3 days apart, actually.
So the first one you got, you had to know you're not allowed to drive with a bad tag.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you fixed it?
Yes, ma'am.
The fact that you fixed it is the only thing that's going to keep you out of jail. If you hadn't fixed it, yours was going to be jail. The first time it's civil, we forgive you.
Yes, ma'am.
To drive again when you know it's bad, that's a criminal act.
Yes, ma'am.
You fixed it 10/20. It took you 3 weeks to fix it. If I get an, if I see another case that you got a third one.
No, ma'am. This is it right here.
Okay. All right. I'm not making it civil because you made a bad choice to continue to drive when you knew it was bad, but I won't make a jail time. I find you guilty of an expired tag, your second one in a month, and it's 6 months probation. You can get off of probation as soon as you pay $250. The mandatory costs are like $273. And here is your paperwork back. Are you entering a no contest plea?
Okay. Can you spell that again? I gotta go to probation?
Yes, this is a criminal act. I could send you to jail for 2 months for this.
Yes, ma'am.
If you'd rather do straight jail time, I'll make it 5 days in jail.
Now, I can pay $250 and not have to report to probation?
If you pay it today.
Can I pay it tomorrow?
Nope. If you can pay it today, you don't need to be on probation. After today, you can get off of probation as soon as you pay the $250. If you pay it tomorrow, you're off of probation tomorrow. But you have to pay, the first month of probation is $65. So if you can't pay it today and you have to wait till tomorrow, you have to pay probation $65. So you may as well wait a few weeks to pay it under that circumstance.
Well, I'm not going to take the jail time. I'm going to pay the money. And I have, what, till 5 o'clock today to pay it?
You have to report to probation right now and tell them that you're going to pay it before 5, and that'll be fine. Just give them a heads up so they don't come back and say he didn't report and you get in trouble.
That's not including the court costs, correct?
The $250 is a fine.
Yes,
in addition to the $250 and the $65 for probation, you have to go to the payment plan, the mandatory cost window, and that starts out at $273. That's the least it can be. Sometimes it's more than that. There are investigative costs or et cetera. In your case, I think it is just the $273, yes? It's just the $273. And you can sign up for a payment plan and make payments on that.
Okay.
Okay, yes, what?
I'll pay the $250.
So you're going to enter a no contest plea.
Yes, ma'am.
Finding you guilty of driving a second time with the expired tag. I'm putting you on 6 months probation. You can get off of probation as soon as you pay $250. If you pay the $250 today, you don't even need to begin probation.
Yes, ma'am.
You have to go to the payment plan room and sign up for the $273 in addition to the other.
Yes, ma'am.
Not a good decision to drive again.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, next. Yes, ma'am. Your name?
Lisa Huff.
Ms. Huff, it appears to me that this should be charged as a felony, given that you've had a prior theft charge before.
I'm not aware of a prior theft.
Okay, the prosecutor wrote me a note, and this history is just as big as the lady who just went into jail. But the prosecutor said, maybe this isn't you. So let's investigate if all this is you.
Okay.
Were you born in North Carolina?
No, ma'am.
You were not?
No, ma'am.
All right.
Okay. Right, you're freaking me out for a minute. Okay, no.
A very depressing day having people with histories. All right, you've been sworn in.
Yes, ma'am.
Right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you. You don't have to answer me, but if you answer me, it needs to be the truth, and obviously we're being recorded. You heard me talk to the three or four people at the table when we first began about pretrial intervention. If you've never been in trouble before, this charge would allow you to take pretrial intervention. And if you complete the conditions, the charges are dropped. But you would know better than I, since this isn't you, if you've ever been in trouble with the law before. Are you eligible for pretrial intervention?
No, ma'am.
Okay. If you have a prior theft charge, a second, and certainly a third, could be charged as a felony. So, if you wish to enter a not guilty plea today, you just need to know when the prosecutor regroups with the right history, if you've had prior theft charges, they may treat it as a felony.
No, ma'am.
Okay, so you've had prior something, but not theft.
No, ma'am, no theft charges. No felony charges, nothing like that.
Okay, so let me go back over this. All right, this was stealing things from, I think it's Bell's. Let me, Bell's. All right, if you enter a no contest plea, I would find you guilty. I'd put you on 6 months probation. You can get off of probation as soon as you complete the shoplifting class, pay a $200 fine, no return to Bell's, restitution if there is any. You'd have a right to have a hearing if you disagree with the amount. Looks like they may have gotten everything back, but if they didn't, you would have to pay restitution if they couldn't sell it. They said they have a DVD. I don't know if there was video, there was a surveillance video. So they have a DVD apparently of you going into the dressing room holding things in your hand and coming out without holding things in your hand. I think that, and then they found stuff in your purse. Okay, that's what they say here. So if you plead today, I'd find you guilty. I'd put you on 6 months probation. You can get off of probation as soon as you complete the shoplifting class, a $200 fine. You're not to return to Bell's. You must pay restitution if there is any. You reserve your right to have a hearing if you disagree with the amount.
I'll take that.
All right. You'll need to be fingerprinted and report to probation outside the double doors.
One question, is the I'm off probation once I complete the shoplifting class?
Once you complete the shoplifting class and pay the $200.
Okay.
And the restitution if there is any.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Next. Yes, ma'am, your name, please. Oh, your name. What? And who's with you?
My mother.
And this is a violation of probation.
This is Christine.
Hi, I have in here with for a violation of probation.
Uh-huh.
I have the recommendation from Mr. Deaton.
This is Tony.
Yes, and it says he recommends probation be terminated, that he's not a good candidate. And how old are you now?
16.
He didn't complete his community service?
I completed all my maximum time in DJJ. They said they couldn't hold me no longer.
You were in the Department of Juvenile Justice?
Yeah.
You were locked up?
Yeah, I was locked up.
Mister, do you have that he was locked up?
Well, the history of his supervision indicates that he was reinstated.
But he said he was at, I'm going to send him out to talk to you. Could you check in? He says he was locked up the maximum amount of time. So I'm going to send him out for you to double check on that.
Okay.
Thanks. Go out to Miss Christine, because I don't have here that you were locked up at all.
He spent 25 days.
On what?
The driving.
On the case I'm handling?
Well, no, there was the two sides of it.
All right, go out and talk to probation because I don't see it and I don't understand how he got it.
Right
outside the double doors, little room on the left, and then you'll all come back and explain to me what judge's order got you locked up. I got a printout from Judge Davis. Did you find... he did do time in detention.
I just spoke with Stephanie from Teen Court, and she looked up the on JJIS. And according to those records, from April 4th through 17th was 14 days that he did on this case.
On this case? The case we have in front of us?
Right. Apparently he was in the juvenile detention center related to this case.
He had a different no valid driver's license that Judge... He had two separate ones.
Okay.
All right, so...
But the August incarceration from the 14th to the 18th is for a non-related case. Those days do not count towards this case.
Okay, but that was for another no valid. Judge Davis sent him. Mr., what concerns me is what was the interaction earlier? Deputy Endahar? I know he was rude in the past, and Judge Davis locked him up for contempt of court. Today, what happened?
He was playing with his phone, and they had asked him to shut it off, and he said some words that were not very nice. And then the gentleman that runs the veterans,
yes,
he said some very nasty words to him as well. That's why I took him outside.
Do you think we're talking about a mental health issue, or is he just mean? I beg your pardon?
You kept messing with me.
All right, that's contempt of court right there. All right, go over there and put the cuffs on him. I'm speechless. Mr. Argento? Hello? Yes. Do you have a moment to help me? Are you still in juvenile court? I mean, that's still your... All right. I have a young man. Judge Davis had sent him to detention in August. He did 5 days for contempt of court. He came in my courtroom today and is using the F word and whatever. So I want to hold him in direct criminal contempt. I need your help. Yes, please. And bring your guidebook with you or whatever you need to bring. Mr. Argento, come on up to the microphone if you would be so kind. All right, do you wish to inquire for direct criminal contempt?
Has the court already, Your Honor, stated the basis for the record?
For the record, this is wrong. And he has chosen to use inappropriate language in the courtroom, including the F word. And so we are having a direct criminal contempt hearing. Wait a minute. For the direct, I initiated it by saying it.
Yes, Your Honor.
Summary procedure is appropriate. So since it's direct, I can do it right now. I don't need to put it in that part in writing. I inform him of the accusation against him. I've told you your language was inappropriate. And then you... Which time? Something is wrong.
I'm fixing to get back to school.
I don't think you belong in school with other people who can control themselves better than you can control yourself. Now, I don't know if you're just mean to the bone and that's what we've got, or if you have a mental health issue. We need to do the best we can for you so that you can live in society. You made everybody around you uncomfortable. You offended me. You were rude to the officer. I'm talking to you right now. You either don't know how to behave or you can't make yourself behave appropriately.
I'm trying to work.
How?
I've been working with my mom.
No, it's not enough. You're scary. You are scary. And I don't know if it's because you're just a mean person and you're going to end up in prison, or if it's a mental health situation that we can help you if we get you some mental health treatment.
I think it's the same issue because my dad's in prison too.
Well, you're heading in that direction with your mouth. Your mouth is going to end you up in that direction. So, I find you guilty of criminal contempt. The apology is nice for what it's worth, but I think you need way more help. And so my choice would be 5 more days in the detention center.
Yes, Your Honor.
I'm glad that I am not going to be his probation officer, but I think he needs some serious help that we haven't addressed.
Your Honor, if you give him the time and secure detention, that's all you could give him for the criminal contempt.
So I can find him guilty and sentence him to 5 days in juvenile detention, suspended upon him satisfactorily completing a reinstatement on probation with the special condition being mental health evaluation, any treatment recommended.
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you want to go ahead and just do the 5 days and get it over with back to Ocala? Or do you want to go back on probation, and the condition of probation is that you're going to have a mental health evaluation and we're going to get you some counseling so hopefully you can learn how to behave in public?
Like a drug test thing to get you started.
They may also do drug testing. I don't know if drugs are causing you to act so horrible. All right, Mom, what's your input? He's already said before he would rather do 5 more days than change.
He needs to do the days, because if he doesn't, what ends up happening is what we've already done, which is I keep driving here every couple weeks and bringing him here every couple weeks, and he doesn't try and put the effort forth for himself.
Okay, and so we're going to do the 5 days, and you're going to call and see if we can get him counseling while he's locked up.
I can call over there, Your Honor.
Yes, sir.
You're breaking your mom's heart. This is so sad. I've seen a lot of sad things today. This is really sad that you've got a healthy body, and apparently you do not have a healthy mind, and we need to get you some help.
I do the 5 days, but what's the counseling?
They're going to try to teach you that you can't just say what you want to say. You can't just do what you want to do. You have to behave a certain way in public. And the rest of us may want to do, I may want to come and punch you in the face right now. I'm not doing it because I know that's not appropriate behavior. You do whatever you want to do without worrying about what's appropriate behavior. And we need to get you on track to understand you can't do that. And you're wearing your mom out. You're wearing me out. All right, so Mr. Argento, I'm fine. I need you to do a, can it be on this same court sheet, or we need a separate court sheet?
However be your discretion, Your Honor. I've seen it done on the same court sheet. He'd be adjudicated delinquent of a contempt action or guilty.
Okay, so we're gonna do it on his, we're gonna terminate probation. And any money due goes to mandatories. And I find him guilty of, you have to say, direct criminal contempt for bad language and rude behavior in court. And he's remanded to the Department of Juvenile Justice for 5 days.
Yes, Your Honor.
Anything else I need to do?
No, Your Honor.
All right. I wish you good luck getting your head turned. If when you're in detention you disobey what they tell you to do, then I guess they put you in isolation. I don't know what they do. Yes?
What about the charge that we came here for?
Closed. The money he owes gets added to the mandatories, but probation is over. I don't know what else to do.
Your Honor, I might stand down having no further business.
Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor.
12-1-3 or 9. It's got to be a mental health issue.